मृत्युंजयाय नमः
measure. When he speaks, He takes us to the very core of Bhagavan's teachings with all its profundity. When he interacted with Bhagavan in his own inimitable style of wit and humor, he reminds us of Tenali Ramakrishna. When he sings, he reminds us of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, totally losing his body consciousness. His youthful exuberance is infectious, such that youths would like to emulate him. Brothers and sisters, no guesses, he is the one and only Professor Anil Kumar. Professor Anil Kumar started his career as a professor in botany in Andhra Christian College, Guntur, where he served for 26 years. To quote him, "Since plants do not speak, I speak on their behalf." He was the state president of the Seva organization, Andhra Pradesh, for 4 years, since 1985 to 89. He was a principal of Sri Sathya Sai Institute of Higher Learning here in Brindavan campus for 6 years. He is the author of 26 books. He gives talks every Sunday at Prashantarium, which is uploaded to a website. You can all visit this website. It is www.saiwisdom.com. He was translator of Bhagavan's Divine Discourses since 1989. He has a passion to talk to youngsters. He has traveled widely all over the world spreading Bhagavan's message. He is presently a professor in Biosciences Department at Prashantarium. Today, he is going to share with us and speak on the topic, Sai, the Eternal Charioteer. I now kindly invite Professor Anil Kumar to take over the mic. Professor Anil Kumar.
With pranam to the divine lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan, revered elders, my dear young friends, my coming to Brindavan is something like homecoming. I am not a guest here. And because this place where I have been brought by Bhagavan, it was in Madras, now Chennai, when Bhagavan was on visit. He called me and said, "I want you to come to Brindavan as the principal of my college," for which I was not prepared for several reasons. Since Swami openly asked me to come there, I immediately fell at his feet and said yes. And thereafter, I made arrangements to make a trip to Brindavan then. That was how I was brought by Bhagavan, and not by application. You don't have my application even now there. I came to Swami by invitation. It is my privilege. Then what am I to talk this evening? I know that this audience is heterogeneous. We have students, youngsters who have not seen Bhagavan. Some might have heard, some might not have seen, might not have heard, Pakka novice, totally new. And some seniors and Bhishmacharya stature, Sri Gangadhara Sachidharu. So we have people of 3 to 4 generations. I have a word to every one of them. Let me first of all, from the bottom of my heart, congratulate the state of Karnataka for organizing summer course. The whole and the soul credit goes to President Dakappa, State President, Sathya organization, Karnataka. I also convey my deep sense of appreciation to my good friend who maintained the campus as before, Principal Sanjay Sahani. I also find among the audience old friends, Mr. Mehta of Alembic, who is here, whom I know very, very intimately. I also recognize the presence of Mr. Nagaya, the district president of those days. I know him very intimately. And the one who addressed you this afternoon, Mr. Srinivasarao, is my good old friend for about 40 years at least, who is here, and so happy that he is here this afternoon. And I have special regard and respect for one thing. In Sai festivals, Sai ceremonies, all certain rituals that we have, there is one gentleman who caught the attention at the international level. He is invited to different countries like Malaysia, Indonesia. And Bhagavan is so pleased with him, and Swami made a comment that he is second to none. My humble salutations, Sri Nandulaya Dikshitulu, who is here. Just 15 days of difference. A gentleman has as much of service I have in Sai fold, almost 23 years. I joined 15 days after he joined here. We were good neighbors. And he has been serving this place most sincerely ever since Mr. Bhatia of Brindavan campus. I really appreciate it. My friends, things are not built in a day. Rome is not built in a day. Many people gave their lives. Many people sacrificed. Bangalore today is totally different from Bangalore in the past. When this campus or one or two buildings appeared, those days, years ago, full of ant hills and a thick forest, Kalupudi, thick forest, that's all. All snakes, nobody to take care of, nobody to help, nobody to maintain, but there lived one gentleman, very sincere, who gave his life to Swami, the like of whom I have not met. He considered Bhagavan more than his children. He considered Bhagavan more than his wife. One day, Bhagavan said, "See, your wife is talking loudly. This man is so sincere." He took her back to her native place, dropped her Swami went on pestering, come on, bring her back there. No, Swami, I'm sorry, she's talking loudly. Ultimately, Swami had to say, in a dictatorial voice, would you get her or not, or shall I send you out? Then he brought. And a gentleman who lost his son, and Bhagavan told him not to inform his wife. The husband and wife traveled together. This gentleman did not inform his wife about the death of their son. Because Swami said, don't say that. That is the level of devotion. I don't think that anybody would equal him. People may say that I'm that and this. That's all nonsense. Total surrender in human form, complete dedication, 100% selflessness. There's no iota of selfishness. Total disciplinarian. The Sai world of devotees should take him as the best example. Sri Rama Brahman of Brindavan Temple. Very, very grateful. Very, very grateful. We don't have him now in our midst, but his son is here anyway. So when I think of Brindavan, all these personalities come to my mind. I cannot simply speak on the topic and say, Jai Sai Ram. I can't say that. Because I have become part of Brindavan. I identify totally myself with Brindavan. Every night I used to think what I would do next morning. What is to be added to the campus? How to make it beautiful? I can tell you plainly, with all the courage, when I joined, it was Bhut Bangla, that's all. The whole facility has been given with the help of all my acquainted friends, several volunteers, friends from all over the state, and we will have that facility as you find today. Therefore, I had a vision, a kind of planning, a dream for Brindavan, which we have realized. And I have no regrets for having left, because I will do what all that could be done at the human level. That's all. That satisfaction I have. Thereafter, having come to Brindavan, Bhagavan has given me umpteen number of chances, not one or two. Sai Puriyat Hall, there in Prashantamilayam, was under construction. Bhagavan stayed here for almost one full year, because that was under construction. And students used to come here all the way in batches to have Swami's darshan. Would you believe if I say, Swami asked me to speak almost every day throughout the year that year, what a chance it is. I cannot forget that. And I cannot express my gratitude when he wanted me to follow him wherever he went. Kodaikanal, Puti, Bombay, Delhi, Chennai, Lahore, Kachi, Simla, I accompanied him. You may not believe when I give you a personal note to let you know the power of Sai, the glory of Sai. I am not here to boast man or to blow my trumpet, only to tell how great the one is. I am from a mafussal town, Guntur, in the state of Andhra Pradesh, a town. I had my education in Telugu medium up to the 10th class. Only after coming to college, I started studying in English medium. I completed the post-graduation there at Andhra Pradesh and started working as a professor in the same college where I studied. Such a man, I'm not from any convent or public school or English medium school or Sainik school with $50 and one bag donation with cart load of books hanging on the back of every child? No, not average school. And he brought me from there, made me the translator of his divine talks for 23 long years, which is a record. And maximum number of talks I translated. What more I want? What more I want? I'm not able to believe that it happened. I also listen to my own words as you listen to me. It all appears to be a story. It looks like it has gone into the pages of history, something to reminisce and ponder over. That is my background. In a nutshell, I can say, my friends, if Swami decides, he can make a grass blade into a gigantic machine. If he does not wish, gigantic machine is not even worth of a grass blade. If we are all like this, it is because of Bhagwan only. Had Bhagwan been here, the whole area would have been full. And there will be cars up to the guest house. That is the influence of Bhagwan. That apart, I can also tell you certain special privileges, special occasions I have had in the company of Bhagwan. We were returning from Delhi. It is a small helicopter, 6-seater, that's all. I don't know whether it's good luck or ill luck. Another gentleman joined us at the end. I had no seat. Oh, Swami said, in seat lay there, we have no seat. As Swami talks privately, it is Pakka Rayalaseema accent. As he talks on the dais, it is classical film, there's no doubt about it. Then he said, Papu, seat lay there, we have no seat. Come and sit here. He made me sit at his lotus feet. And then I silently said, Bhagwan, Bombay Delhi trip are coming to a close. The golden dream is disappearing. As children start eating sweets, they're happy to eat, they're unhappy because it is going to be exhausted. It will be complete. That is my situation, Swami. The tour is coming to a close. You know what Baba said? Why do you think the golden dream has come to an end? No. With me, every day is a golden day. That's what Bhagwan said. And further he added, I'll take you wherever I go, and you are going to translate my thoughts. That's what Baba said. I don't think that anybody would love me as much as Bhagwan loved me. I should also tell you openly, because it is known to some of my friends who are here. It so happened, Swami pointed out, Jayamma Gopinath, the warden of Anantapur campus, she also translated Bhagwan's talks into English. Before everybody, Swami asked Anil Kumar, of the two, who is better than the other? She translates, you translate. Who is better than the other? Can I keep my mouth shut? It is not my pattern at all. So I said, I'm more than her. I'm not that stupid yet. I cannot say she's greater than me openly, unless I substantiate it. Then I said, Swami, she hails from Chennai, the center of English learning. In the whole of South India, Chennai is the center of English language and literature. She hails from the place. Whereas I come from a Mafasal town after all. She had her education English all through and did her MA in English literature. And just MSc postgraduate in botany. She did her PhD in English literature. Aurobindo, and nobody's one. How do you compare me with her? I am nobody. Do you know what Baba said? I don't want experts. Because if I bring experts, audience will have to listen to two talks, my talk and expert talk. For me, you are enough, Anil Kumar, you continue. That's what he said. How am I to forget that moment? Speaking at a family level, though personal, I'm least placed in the official dhamma. The elder brother, being chief accounts officer, HAL, Bangalore. The younger brother, internationally known doctor in the field of pathology. The brother-in-law, the retired principal, Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. I was just an ordinary lecturer working in Andhra Christian College at Guntur. My mother was very much worried about me. How this fellow would succeed in his life. How would he get his children married? He goes on saying, Sai Baba, Sai Baba on the road. Nobody would accept his daughters by singing Sai Baba, Sai Baba in marriage to them. She's very mature. She wanted me to become some officer, poor lady. I could not rise to her expectations. I love the teaching profession. I love teaching profession. Given the chance, I would like to be born again and again and again. As a teacher only. Therefore, I have no regrets. No regrets for being a teacher, because I consider myself far superior, greater than other walks of life. No regrets, I'm still happy about it. Swami gave an interview one day, and my mother also was called in for information. He is postgraduate in English literature from Queen Mary's College, Madras, and a gold medalist, retired executive officer. Swami called her inside the interview room and told everybody, Anil Kumar, mother appa, chala strict, chala gatti, English appo chala. He praised her to the skies, her level in English. He's Pakka disciplinarian, I know. And Swami made us sit on a chair. All of us were seated on the ground. And looking, and she's not a devotee. Looking at Swami, somehow she started crying. Most of the ladies only know the language of tears, either happiness or unhappiness. Only language of tears. She was just crying. And my Swami immediately said, why do you cry, Sarvajanamma? In the years ago, why do you cry? Ni kodaku purinchena baadha. I am very much worried about your son. Sai Baba, antavu naadu etukuntunna anukuntaamma. Em chesedi anukuntunnavu? You are very much worried what is to be done. He goes on saying, Sai Baba, Sai Baba. Then he said, chudamma, Sai Baba entha mandiki telusu. నీ కొడుకు కూడా అంతమందికి తెలుస్తాడు అన్నాడు. హి గేవ్ టు భగవాన్ బాబా దట్ డే. షీ వాస్ వెరీ వెరీ హ్యాపీ. వన్ మోర్ పర్సనల్ నోట్. ఇట్ వాస్ అన్ ఒకేషన్ దట్ హీ పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ వెడ్డింగ్ ఆఫ్ మై ఎల్డెస్ట్ డాటర్ ఇన్ హిస్ ఓన్ డివైన్ స్టైల్. ఇట్ ఇస్ ఆల్ హిస్ countless blessings. I don't think that I deserve them all. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, some have greatness thrust upon them. Perhaps I belong to the third category. And Swami gave service as usual on the wedding day. The wedding was over. Next day, after the wedding, Swami was telling two sarees. One blue, one gold color. Swami's style of walking. Wow, one should watch that. Does he walk? No. Does he run? Certainly not. Does he float? Appears to be. Does he dance? Why not? He walks like that. So beautiful, holding both the sarees. And the varala before everybody, he called me and said, are the two colors, which color is good? I said, Swami, sea is blue, sky is blue, Rama is blue, so I have nothing to say about blue color. About the gold color, gold is most precious thing these days. So, I don't want to be against the gold color anyway. Both the colors are nice. Then Baba said, Chiki, ye matla matla color. Radha, ye lage? Idi, dharma varam sari. Idi, kanchi sari. Ippu chepu chustam? This is a sari from dharma varam. This is from kanchi. You say, which is good? Then immediately said, Swami, you are very close to dharma varam. Can I say no to Dharmavaram? No. You are very close to Dharmavaram. Saiswari, close to Dharmavaram. And Kanchi, Kamakshi, she will catch my neck. I cannot say, Swami, both are great. Please leave me. Then Baba said, no. Yemra, clever guy, Jabtaunda. Yemra, no. Not correct. To your mother, which color is good? I said, Swami, it is a known fact that she was the college beauty during her college studies. Yes, she is the most beautiful lady. Any color given to her would be colorful. There is no doubt about it, I said. Chana. Then I added, Swami, please don't give her. Please don't give her. Yeah, matla jata hoga. Any chilla, any permission me. When I give, I don't need your permission. Yeah, matla jata hoga. No regret, ya musko. Shut your mouth tight. Swami, no musko kangan bhoto. I shut my mouth, but don't give her. Then Swami said, give me, why? Swami, you gave sari yesterday to her along with others. If you give any extra sari now, it will lead to Korean War at home among the ladies. I am peaceful now. Please allow me like this. Then Swami laughed. Then he said, Chudu, Ninnu cheerulu andarito paatu ichinanu. Velli varandarito paatu ichinanu. Ee naadu mee ammaku ninnu naaku ichindi kada andukani istunnanu. Today's sari is different because she has given you to me. It is in that appreciation I am giving you. How can I forget those moments? How can I forget? Therefore, that apart, I would like to draw your attention to some special occasions, the like of which I don't think that's possible. Anybody could witness, I don't think so. Swami, you have two buttons to his shirt. Two buttons. Clear? And it so happened that morning, he didn't put one button. When he did not put one button, what happens? There will be space there, right? You can try for yourself. So, there is space there. I was watching his face and the space. Both I watched. Swami said, yeah, this was down low. Why did you watch him? We can't say publicly that kind of thing. No. Slowly I went close to him. What the place is Swami? We did not put buttons, Swami. Space. Then Baba said, yeah, me. Palm was there, Baba, okay? Could snakes get in there? No. Then you know what Baba said? He opened both the buttons and we could see his chest. We could see Shankha and Chakra on his chest. That's what it is. It is not possible. I don't know that anybody has seen that. These are private moments, I tell you. I can also tell you another occasion. In places where only a couple of selected students are there, he'll be very, very free. The moment VIPs increase, he'll be reserved. So our students is very free. So he was very free, and I came closer and closer to him. I take divine risk every moment. But he helped me to come out successfully, if not totally lost. I came close to him, and on the left leg, near the ankle, I found a print. Those of you who wear glasses, you'll be knowing, because of constant use, you'll have some mark there, right? Similarly, on the ankle, the right left one, I found some mark, just as ladies wear. Anflexena? Gajal, right? Manukindala note, something like a man note. I have three dots, I know what you use, you know. So there are three. The print is there, wonderful picture. I saw that. Then I lifted another leg, little up. There's no print there. Then I said, Swami, what happened to the other one? Where have you lost? I see the print of one here, anchored. But I don't see to the other leg what happened. ఏం రా పుచ్చిగా మాట్లాడుతూ ఉన్నావు స్వామి ఎవరు అనుకున్నావు అర్ధనారీశ్వరుడు భగవాన్ సచ్ లవ్లీ ఫ్యాంటాస్టిక్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ విత్ హిమ్ బిఫోర్ రీచింగ్ దిస్ ప్లేస్ సమ్ యంగ్స్టర్స్ యూత్ వాలంటీర్స్ హు ఆర్ వెరీ వెల్ నోన్ టు మీ said emphatically that I should share these things with you, as this group comprises young boys and girls who should certainly carry these anecdotes back home to think again and again, so that we think of the majesty and the greatness of Baba, what he is, what he is. For 42 years I've been with him, for 22 years working right under his nose, almost interacting, following him wherever he goes. I know what Bhagwan is, how he acts. Very special occasions. The banquets of lunch or dinner with Bhagwan, a royal class one. You don't find anything Buckingham Palace can afford that standard of a banquet, because Baba is king of kings. Only 14 or 30 items, that's all, not many. You'll have 4 to 5 streams, 4 to 5 hearts. Or you should go, your duty is only to fill up, that's all. You cannot say no. You'll check the plates also, they should be empty. And again, evening snack, just 4 to 5 items. Again, like 25, 30, like for 1 month feeding. All those that go there will add on weight by the time they return. And Swami also jokes, Yemra, itlundav, pakkodi madri, badanyam now, oh, you have put on the weight. And you look at another fellow, Babu now, 4 months, gynec case. 9 months now, Babu. The then situation, he goes on joking with them all. And then at the dining table, you believe me or not, such a king of kings, the greatest of all, does not eat anything other than 3 spoons of ragi, 3 spoons of ragi, 3 or 4, mixed with groundnut chutney. Nadi poor man food, Evelyn, ragi mudda, ni kavala, we want it, not now, Swami. That's all. And then then a curd is served to everybody. The curd is so hard. People from cities may not know that. People from villages may know that. It is so hard, you need a crowbar to break it, you know. Curd is of that quality. Look, that curd is served to everyone. And Swami doesn't eat curd. He doesn't take milk, no coffee, no tea, nothing. And I'm feeling guilty. Swami, you are enjoying curd like you don't take curd. I feel embarrassed to eat when you are not eating. Please take little, Swami, taste little. Baba said immediately, Purva avataramlo bangaru, ee paalu perugu taagi tini visiyetti poyindaya. And then Ganeshani. I had this milk and curd repeatedly and disgusted with that, so I don't want it now. Thus indirectly informing us that is Lord Krishna himself. Lord Krishna himself. And Sai style, one should watch as he sits on the chair. He sits like an emperor. My friends, if time permits, our friends have got number of videos with them. You watch special videos covering birthday and convocation. Birthday and convocation are attended by Prime Minister, President, not less than that. Of the chairs there, Swami's chair, central one, will be higher. President, Prime Minister, that's all. That's all. Rajadina Ajarama Chandra Sai Jagavandana. King of kings, that is his level. And as he sits there like that, let him be Prime Minister or President. That's all. You don't find anywhere commanding right from President level to the dukes. Commanding because is the master, the divine master, the controller of the whole of the universe. I wonder how he talks to people. Very open, very frank. He doesn't unnecessarily praise people, no. There is a matter to check, he will openly say that. President Venkatraman, President of India, he was the chief guest for one of the convocations. He was on the dais. What did Baba say? Why not you people offer free education to everybody all over India? Why not? What is that you are doing there in Delhi? Who can question like that? A supreme commander of the stature of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba can only say that. It is also the occasion. Yes. I'm happy that you got the point. It was the time when S.B. Chauhan, the Union Minister of Housing and Rural Development, Union Minister, he sat there on the dais. You know what Baba said? ఈ దేశంలో అనేకమంది మంత్రులు ఉంటూ వచ్చినారు. గ్రామాభివృద్ధికి సంబంధించిన మంత్రులు వచ్చుకున్నారు. ఒక్క మంత్రి కూడా ఒక గ్రామమునకు పోపిన బాబాన పోలేదు. ఎయిర్ కండిషన్ రూమ్ లో కూర్చుంటారు, గ్రామం యొక్క సేవలు రాస్తారు. ఇది దేశం యొక్క దౌర్భాగ్యం. హూ కెన్ సే దాట్? సత్య సాయి బాబా మినిస్టర్స్ ఇన్ చార్జ్ ఆఫ్ హౌసింగ్ అండ్ రూరల్ డెవలప్మెంట్. They are seated comfortably in the air-conditioned rooms there in Delhi. Pass on orders about rural development in India. That is ugly situation in this country. Who can say that right on the face? Right on the face. Yenu gettunada nambalam uyanu kapadado Attulainaru palatiyunu neru Just as elephant is not aware of its own strength, Bharatiyas do not know how powerful they are, how strong they are. That's what Bhagavan says. He has got very high expectations, my friends, boys and girls. Very high expectations. He considers everybody less than the youth of this country. All are less than. Suppose he is Prime Minister and you, he will talk to you and not to the Prime Minister. Such an importance it is for the country of the country. Such an importance. Yuga yugantara munayati Urimida khyati kannatti bharata bhumata kirti Yuga yugantara munayati khyati kannatti bharata bhumata kirti Saya siddhantamula cheta vanne petti sana pettudu meerika Sana pettudu meerika sunidamuna What a clarion comment is. This is Bharat that has been repeated for ages. Bharat is the leader for the whole world. Bhagavan says the youth of this country should carry his message by sharpening their intellect that is revealed to youngsters. What a call it is. Therefore, summer goes. Indian culture and spirituality meant inculcation of patriotic spirit. Patriotism, that's most important. Bhagavan said, Videshalalo kondalu dochukunnatte Bharatdeshamlo kondalu kalagatam veru banga. These are burning money on the sides of the mountains. Better you wash your utensils and carry your life. That is the spirit of Bhagavan. We can say that I am a Sai student. I can say I love Sai. If you have got that political, that national fervor and commitment. Khanda khandantara kyadinar chunchina mahani yulanu gamna matrubhumi vacha chadirula paradronichiyo Swatantramugamna samarabhumi Chitra kalavadoda Chitramayam natti chitra bhumi Sangeeta sahitya shastriya vijalandu Dhi shakti jubila diya bhumi Atti bharata mata bhagyam nukamana Atti bharata mata bhagyam mukabara Pachatantayumire vijatulara Pachatantayumire vijatulara That is the appeal of Bhagavan to the youth of this country. India that has been known far and wide for its history and legacy and heritage, for all the rich spiritual treasure it has. The only country that could win the freedom by observing non-violence, the land of art, literature, is the duty of the youth to uphold the pristine glory of Bharat, that is the appeal of Swami. So when you think of summer goals, if I am successful in my talk to make you more patriotic, to make your country love more, yes, the summer course has done its job. It is not information. It is not quotations. No. People are fed up with lectures. People are disgusted with quotations. People will watch our lives. What a spirit of sacrifice you have. What a kind of commitment you have. How are you prepared to carry the touch of Sai message to the doorsteps of everybody? That is the spirit of summer course. Now going back to those days, let me tell you how Bhagavan loves students. First of all, he will establish the divinity in their minds. They will make them feel that he is no less than God. Then starts joking. Then starts the divine romance, not till then. We feel his presence, we will know that it is divine, nothing less than that. to tell you an anecdote. Swami is a jovial man, very funny, full of wit. Then suddenly, any question, you adagandi, come on, ask questions. Swami, simple question. Really, what? How is it that Lord Krishna has 8 wives? Not nice to hear. 8 wives. You matladutam bhava. Why do you ask like that? Swami, God having 8 wives, not nice. I cannot tell anybody, Krishna has 8 wives. Then Baba said, you too have 8 wives. Then God, my wife was not there. He said, you too have 8 wives. Where are they? Then? Swami, where are they? Swami said, your heart is a lotus flower with 8 petals. There are 8 wives of every human being. Who can say that? Only Krishna can say that. No one else. Swami, good account we have given. How about 16,000 affair? Who becomes there? How about that account? And yeah, I'm the Sinema Krishna Yatavala. You are speaking about Sinema Krishna. Chi. 16,000. You too have this. 16,000 I have. Yes. Where are they? Here in Sahasra, there is Sahasra Padma, 1,000 petals of lotus here. Each petal has 16 shades. 16,000, 16,000. You too have it. Who can say that? Sathya Sai Baba only. Nobody can say that. I have not heard. There are a couple of temples right in front of our house there at my native place. Right from my childhood, I have been listening to all Quran in the temple of premises, but nobody could say that. And our dear God explained such a way that Lord Venkateshwara, raising one hand like that, another hand like this. Why can't he lift both hands like that? Or put both hands down like Jesus Christ? Why? Swami, he can do that, or he can do that. Why this? Then Baba said, Patukora, Nabhayami Pukundra, catch hold of my feet, I protect you. Who can tell you? Come on. Only Sathya Baba can say. And he didn't leave at that stage. You see, when the bus stops close to Tirupati, you find there's a road leading to the seventh hill. How is the road? Zigzag way. Something like the snake, irregular direction. Seventh hill, you have Lord Venkateshwara. What does it mean? The bus has to go through all the zigzag route and has to take you to Lord Venkateshwara. Baba says, this zigzag route is Kundalini, your vertebral column. It takes you across 6 hills, Shat Chakra, and takes you to Sahasrara, the 7th chakra, where Lord Venkateshwara resides. That is your body structure. The ascent of Kundalini is the symbol behind the route to Tirupati. Who can say that? Lord Venkateshwara. Then there was another question. Swami, how is it that God loves our hair? We offer hair to Lord Venkateshwara, which we can get it in 1 month's time. Waste. Swami said, Tuchamena Mutsukosan Kadrahana. It is not your mean hair that God wants. And Swami says, hair is the one that you like very much. If anyone stands in front of the mirror, how do I look? Okay? They will start adjusting it, including such a Sai Baba. You should see him how nice he is. Just like that. So, the hair represents your love. Now, you want to look handsome. Then once you offer that hair, You are surrendering your ego. Well, what all I love, I give it to you. And hair which is black in color represents tamo guna, the bestial or animalistic tendencies. Then once I offer the black hair, all the animality is offered to God. That is the symbol. Who can say that? Lord Venkateshwara, Sai Swara, only can say. If you ask me, my friends, what is it that attracted you towards Swami? Personally speaking, I come from a family of Brahmo Samaj, founded by Raja Ramon Roy for three generations. We don't believe in idolatry. We don't believe in these rituals. We believe in the holistic doctrine of God without a beginning and an end. God who is all pervasive. That is the philosophy of Brahmo Samaj. It is rather strange that I landed from Brahmo Samaj to Baba. Once Swami remarked in Brindavan, "Yeh, Brahma ledu, Samajam ledu. Chivari Brahma dekhiye chhedna kadaiya." There neither Brahma nor Samaja. Ultimately, you reach in Brahma only. That's what Baba said. Therefore, dear friends, if you ask me what is it that brought you to the lotus feet of Swami, His divine message, wonderful message, His talk, and variety of things He says, in myriad ways, variety of ways. Nothing is a repetition. You can listen to Him time and again. No repetition, something novel, something unique emerges in His divine discourse. I was told that there are many new people here. To those veterans, the confirmed, established, old timers, it may be same thing for them. But to you youngsters, it is something unbelievable. You don't find any Hindu going to Mecca, do you? No. You don't find any Muslim going to Ananda Padmanabha Swami temple. He won't. You don't find any Hindu going to Vatican. You don't find any Christian going to Hanuman temple. Each religion has got its own temple. And people belong to that religion go to that particular place, kshetra only. But today all over the world, open challenge. Yes, you can question me. If there is any place all over the world where people of all religions gather and sit in perfect harmony, it is Prashantinale of Brahman. And second thing is this, usually temples are the places, pilgrim centers are the places that attract retired people, grand old people who have enough of rest at home, will have rest of the rest at the temples. Lean on a pillar, sleep, as the priest gives some talk. That's what it is. Elderly people go to temples usually. But there is one place where elementary school children, high school children, college-level students, university students, youngsters, professionals, engineers, doctors, architects, people of different professions, people of different age groups, if they are present at one place, that is Prashanti Nilayam. And it's also rather surprising, if I let you know, that we have not heard the names of certain countries like El Salvador, like Peru, like Guatemala, like Dominican Republic. These names were Croatia. These names we have not heard. Name the country that represented you there in Prashantinale. Prashantinale is global, international, cosmic in its constitution. People of all countries gather over there. All religions gather there. And it's most surprising, there are many, many, many foreigners who come there, though they do not know English nor any Indian language. They don't know Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, or Hindi, nothing. Not even English, but they come there. But their face is full of smiles. If you find some smiling faces, faces with satisfaction, they are from foreign countries only. If you find some oily castor oil faces, are old-time devotees, you can take it from here. All foreigners full of smiles. They are very happy by looking at here. Ask them why they smile. Swami, Swami, what from? If Swami looks at them, they will celebrate. If Swami takes a letter, they will dance. If they get an interview, wow, they are on the top of the world. Because that yearning, that devotion brought them to their lotus feet. Whereas you and I am not happy when you are given interview. And rather, I fast tonight if you get Pada Namaskar. I pray to Swami, Swami, whether you look at me or not, don't look at so and so. Indian prayer. But they are not like that. They are not like that. What do they want, Swami? Swami, that's all. They get all the through. And what do they understand? In public meetings, they sit there. And what do they understand? I don't know. Whereas those people that know, sometimes go to Samadhi, the sleeping condition. Some of our students are yogis, you know. They can sleep with their eyes open. Yes, above Mahasiddhi. But these foreigners, though they don't know the language, yet they listen to it. If you ask them, we understand. Huh? You understand? I don't understand. How you understand? I understand. Why? Madhuramayina bhasha manulagalamuto bhakta koti hrudini bhakti cheyu suti mada kaliki Sufma dharmam gule chepu chundu Sai upu mire Suti maata paliki Sufma dharmam gule chepu chundu Sai upu mire. He himself described in his wonderful, lovely composition how his discourses are. Madhura maina bhasha. His language madhura. Rhyme. That beautiful language. Manjulagalamuto, melodious voice, musical voice. Bhakta koti hrudini bhakti cheyu. His clarion call, the divine message, his message will satisfy all people of all levels at the same time, at the same place. Impossible for anybody to do that. Ask one lady, how is Swami's speech? The grandmother says, I'm 90, but nobody spoke like this. Oh. You are a Sanskrit scholar? I read many Sanskrit scholars. No scholar gave this interpretation. You ask a scientist, what a scientific development it is. You talk to an artist, art is such Sai Baba. Suti mata paliki, sukshma dharmam bule chepu chundu. He speaks straight. Straight, that's all. There's no ambiguity. There's no confusion. Because as we attend some talks, at the end, we have to question what is that he has spoken. What is his subject? Swami is not like that. Wonderful talk. Suti mata paliki. Sukhma dharma mule chepu chundu. The subtleties, the subtle dharmas are communicated straight away in a subtle way. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. my friends, what we have to constantly remember today, I can go on speaking for any length of time like this, because I am acquainted with the divine person, Bhagavan Baba, physically, having been his translator for 23 years. I can go on and anything for any number of days together. But my aim is to touch upon varied topics meant for different groups here, of age groups here, organization and otherwise. Somebody has asked a question. I'm sure the two people who made their presentations this evening, a boy and a girl, they did a very good job, very good job. Their English is good, narration is good, subject is good, understanding is good, and you are good. There's no doubt about it. Therefore, I'm sure how sharp you are, how intelligent you are, in full awareness of that. I'll pass on to you some more information. Somebody asked Swami, Bhagavan, how shall I spread your message? The fellow is very much interested to spread his message. Swami said, stop that. Follow my message, that's more important than translating, than spreading my message. Following his message. Supposing I say, there's only one language, the language of the heart. But if I go on loving my own people, my own Telugu fellows, my own Urdu fellows, I'm a stupid number one. My friends, so far, people listen to Bhagavan's discourses. So long we said, Swami, you said my life is my message, let our life be your message. It is only a platform declaration. With the physical withdrawal of Bhagavan, after Divya Mahasamadhi, the whole world will look at you. Every person on the street will examine you. To what extent you are following his message. Suppose I say, love all sattva, love all sattva. Sir, what is the time now? Get up! Lord, love us. Stop it. It's an insult. If we cannot translate into action, if we cannot practice, better we don't do that. So Swami said, the best way to spread his message is to follow his message. Walk the talk, that's what he said. There are many people who say, Swami, you are great, education free, hospital free, water free, what is that free talk? Stop it. What does Baba say there? What is free? Yes. Education is free. Why not? Hospital medical care is free. Why not? God is free. So God actions are free. Our God is not expensive. For Baba Darshan, there is no 5 rupee ticket. For Baba Namaskar, there is no 150 rupee ticket. There is no money for prasadam. You see, prasadam size, there is whatever, do you know that? On the day of distribution of prasadam, canteen is closed. So much of prasadam is getting in veterinary doses. Yeah. And he finds that you are eating nicely. I very well remember, on the diet Swami sits, and they serve Prihodari. Kalkunja Agrahara has got Oxford standard of Prihara. Yeah, their preparation is different. I know that. Puliyara and Pongal, number one, I know. Vaishnavis, they do it well. So, Swami sits there and they serve prasad, Puliyara and Pongal. I'll be sitting there. Swami will watch like that. But we are very busy, how can we look at him? Particularly when Puliyara is so tempting with all his fragrance, fresh from the canteen. And watch it. Then slowly it comes close to him. Bhagundara, is it nice? Abbo Swami Brahmanda. they're very nice. Are you Rana? He seems to like it. Brahma Namada. Ide Brahma, Asal Brahma Tungaru, Yemoye. Uliara is Brahma for him. How does Brahma look? And he calls the boy, right? Serve him one more spoon. Then he says, very nice, something extra. I also remember Major Mahadeva, the former state president of Tamil Nadu, bringing carrier to take prasad. Even carrier reaching away, Baba. Satchasaya, Annapurnalaya, Annapurna. Yes, there is nothing like it is over, nothing like that. At this moment, I should tell you, there in Kodaikanal, what happened was, more than the number expected turned up for Narayan Seva. They prepared for 1,000 or two. 4,000 to 5,000 fellows came there. All the stuff, food in the kitchen is over. You can talk to Mrs. Ratanlal, who is in Prashantanilayam, to certify the validity of my statement. I was quite new to Swami. They called me, kitchen people called me. Please tell Swami that stuff is exhausted. I go in the Chapandiyala. Because that being quite new, fools rush in where angels fear to tread. So simply I came to Swami. I go in the Chapandiyala. All that stuff in here, I go in that Namaskar. I go in Namaskar. Never say, I go in the over, no. You go inside the upper kitchen, he said. I ran. Believe me, my friends, all the big vessels are full of rice, sambar, everything there. Then I came up, Swami said, Am I going, Daya? No, Swami said, I'm going, Daya. These are things I watch, you see, personal. I'm sure that none of you will doubt these statements. So we people say, to glorify Baba, that is free. Swami, how shall we glorify you? How are you to be glorified? How are you to be praised? Do you know what Baba said? You don't have to praise me. No, Nanguya, you are a sannyasi. Why do that you praise me? Your devotion, your faith, your detachment, your love will glorify me, not your publicity stunt. Therefore, to glorify Baba, we should have the spiritual detachment, total love towards Him. Swami, many people say, I am Baba devotee. As if it's a Rotary Club or Lions Club. Some people say, I am a senior devotee. As if you get few increments. Our promotion. Nonsense. Swami, how am I to know that I am a devotee? Shall I say I am a devotee? Some whispering comes also. Do you know what Baba said? You are my devotee when you place yourself at my feet totally without ego, then only you are my devotee. Without ego, when we surrender to you totally, then only we can call ourselves His devotee. Swami, how lucky we are. Are we lucky? Are we? So if I am lucky, what am I to do? If I am lucky, what should I say? I should say, I am lucky. We heard it enough. Please stop. How am I to tell everybody how lucky I am? Baba said, share your experience. Share the love that you developed. Share the spirit of sacrifice you have. That is the way of sharing your experiences your love, Swami experiences with others. That's what Bhagavan has said. Some people say, I am close to Bhagavan. Ignorance number one. If anyone says, I am close to Bhagavan, he is close to mental hospital. His chapter is closed. No one can be close to God, understand? Or you can put it this way, all are close to God. Who is close to earth? We are close to earth. Anyone says, I'm not close to earth? Tomorrow is a holiday. Can anybody say, I'm close to air? All about that we breathe. So you cannot say, I'm closer to air. Better you get yourself observed. Heavy palpitation, maybe there's something wrong. When we are so close to five elements, Pancha Bhutamalu Samipamainapu, Pancha Bhutamalu Nirminchinatuvadu Parameshwaranu, Inka Samipasthulamanu, we are closer to God who created these five elements. It is foolishness and ignorance to think that I am close to God. And what does Baba say? Closeness means this. Closeness means you feel me in your heart. That is closeness. Not saying with the lips I am close to God. Better we avoid you tomorrow morning. You should feel His closeness in your heart, but not on the lips. Swami, if I feel you in my heart, what will happen? Baba says, when coal is brought close to the fire, that also gets lighted. That also gets ignited. Similarly, when you feel me in your heart, you feel thrilled and excited. That's the way. All right. Few challenges that Bhagavan has taken. Swami, what do you do? What do you do? You know what he said? I shall not leave you even if you leave me. I shall not leave you. I say, by holding on to me, what do you do? I myself am completely useless. What is for holding on to me? Why? Swami, why do you want me? And I don't want to run away. You say that you will chase me, that you won't leave me. Why? You know what Baba said? I shall not leave you until I fulfill the task I want to through you. When anything is to be done by you, I shall see it is done by you, that's all. I shall not leave you. That's what he said. Doesn't matter even if you respect me. The fact of facts is this. For all these 23 years, I never thought that I would be completing this long period of life. There were many times when I packed my luggage to leave the place. I was ready to leave the place, but Baba did not leave me. Even by leaving the Brindavan, up to the arch there in the Shankaran, I was in two minds, to be or not to be, that is the question. But he has not left me. He'll pull you, drag you, like a crane, cut up and keep it there. How are you? He does it and takes it as a matter of surprise. That's really great. My friends, you're all from the city. I know that you have to go back. The public transport may not be at your beck and call. And Anil Kumar has got this weakness of speaking for hours and days because I get lost myself when I think of his message because of long, long association with him. My appeal to everybody is this. To all elders, to all seniors, to all youngsters of the organization, please understand the difference between them and now. Swami is no longer with us physically. He is within us. He is not in front of you physically. Therefore, I cannot say, Swami told me this, Swami wanted me, I can't. Does it stop it? We have to present, make a presentation as Swami in full awareness of present situation. Swami's message is more important today than ever before. Swami's message must be taken to the doorstep of every day. Very important. Number two, let us not get divided because of positions. Position will never bring any prestige. It is person that brings prestige to the position, but position will never make you prestigious. Let us not fight for positions. Let us not crave for positions. Forget about it. Swami, the highest position is to be your devotee. What more can there be? Let me continue to be your devotee at any cost. Let us forget our differences. Work unitedly. The more loving you are, the more close you are, closer you are, then Baba will be accepted by the newcomers. The distance, your own stories, your own greatness are not valued hereafter. Baba's universal message. Baba has to be spread. Baba's mission has to be spread by way of service, unity of religions, love, sacrifice. That's most important. Let us not reduce Bhagwan Baba as a miracle man. You know what Baba said about miracles? 1972, summer course, he said, miracles are like mosquitoes falling on my body. I am of the size of an elephant. Miracles are mosquitoes. You care for mosquitoes, forgetting the elephant. So let us think of the elephant, mighty divinity of Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba. Spread his message, practice his message, and see that all will be aware of such a Sai divinity and such a Sai message. Take the message to new people. See that love spreads, the unity spreads. That's very, very important. Doesn't matter if we have to compromise on certain issues. Unity today is more important than ever before. Unity of religions, Baba's message, are most important today than ever before. I'm sure that Bhagavan Baba will give us the needed strength, the courage, the skill and the talent, the adequate energy to rise up to his standards of expectations. I really appreciate you for listening to my talk in that attention. In fact, I love to talk even more, but I'm sure those from the city may not attend my next talk because of appearance problem. You children, you stay here because this has been your residence. You like to hear throughout my time now. I pray from the bottom of my heart that Bhagavan should shower his blessings on all of you youngsters who have assembled here. Let me compliment this gesture. State President Dakappa for organizing Bhaktanjali program in the city after Swami's withdrawal from the body, the like of which has not been conducted anywhere. That goes to the Karnataka leadership. God bless you. I am also immensely happy that he is the man who could organize summer course here, made everybody go back to our memory, think of our present moments in association with Bhagwan in the past, and see him right in front of us. This experience has been extended to us by the effective planning of President Dakappa of Karnataka State Organization. My compliments to you. And then the whole campus is given to you. As I was moving around the campus, I was feeling of those days when I was to move about here and there. Everything appears to, everything, something beautiful, take me back to those days. Now I am younger, younger by 20 years at least. 20 years at least. The beautiful campus is maintained. The Brindavan culture is kept up. The resourceful personnel and the youngsters, especially Bhagwan, have been serving as effective instruments in this institution. I pray Bhagwan to bless them all, headed by Sanjay Sahani, the principal. Thank you very much, Bhagwan.
I come to see you.
That was a pleasure.
బాగున్నారా అమ్మాయి అబ్బాయి బాగున్నారా చెప్తాను అబ్బాయి ధర్మేంద్ర బాగున్నాడా అమ్మాయి ఎక్కడ ఉంది యుఎస్ లో ఉందా బాగుందా
బాగున్నారా
ఓ హౌ ఆర్ యూ ఓ గుడ్ సరే సరే అండి ఓ
సరే
So nice to meet you all after a long gap of time. Sir came to the room. How are you? Amma.
Mrityunjayaya Namo.
Mrityunjayaya Namo.
Mrityunjaya.